Okay, my name is Guy Wallace. I'm the Southeast Region Wildlife Manager, and I will be presenting the Henry Mountains Bison Management Plan. Now, before we get into the plan, I want to talk a little bit about the process and our committee and bison in general. One thing about bison that we have found that people are very passionate about bison. They are very unique, and not just in Utah. Nationwide, they're one of four free-ranging, hunted, disease-free bison herds in North America. And they live in a tough landscape, especially lately with our recent drought, and primarily on public land. This uniqueness and environment can cause conflicts. This is a rare, once-in-a-lifetime opportunity for a sportsman, and maybe not so much for a livestock producer. These were really hard issues, and this process was not easy. At times, it was really tough. We had a very diverse committee and representation on that committee. We had several hard, candid discussions, and throughout the process, there was a lot of compromise and give and take on both sides. Some wanted more bison, some wanted less. So there were some very difficult issues with no easy answers or resolution. But overall, the committee, there was a genuine motivation to produce a document that while we did not agree on everything, the committee agreed they could live with this plan, and I believe that's where we landed. So with that, I'll get into the plan. The plan was there was a previous plan in 2007, and since 2007, there's been a lot of habitat projects. We have new information about bison use and movements from a study that was conducted by Utah State University. And we put GPS satellite radio collars on animals. And so we have a lot of new information about their movements and habitat use from these collars. And then we've also experienced some really extreme drought years, which has changed things on the habitat side of it. So we felt like there was a need for a plan revision to incorporate all these into the plan. The plan purpose is to provide direction for bison management over the next 10 years. And the plan contains general updated information on history, the status of the herd, habitat issues, issues of concern, and harvest management. Issues of concern was a part where we spent a lot of time. There were a lot of frank discussions about identifying the concerns and then strategies to address these issues wherever possible. The plan outlines the goals, objectives, and strategies for managing bison and their habitat. I want to talk a little bit about the plan committee now again. The plan revision committee was formed in August of 2019, and we met 8 times over 2.5 years. And that was a little longer because of COVID. We hit right in the middle of COVID, and so our meetings were delayed about 6 months because the committee made a decision not to do online meetings. And so we waited until the COVID restrictions were released so that we could meet in person again. It was a 16-person committee representing private landowners, livestock grazing permittees, sportsmen and outfitters, elected officials, and various state and federal agencies. I want to take this time right now to thank all the members that spent all the time and effort on this committee to attend meetings and complete this plan revision. There was a considerable commitment of time and expense to travel and attend these meetings. And the committee's willingness to come and work through this process was very much appreciated. I'm going to talk about the outline of the plan. This is basic outline of how the plan was set up. And as I said before, it provides guidance and directions for the management of the bison herd and their habitat. It has a history and status section and a little bit of information on history. The bison were brought into the Henry Mountains from Yellowstone National Park and released on the Bird Desert in 1941 and 1942. So the herd's been there for about 80 years, and that's a pretty long time, and we've worked through a lot of issues with the bison on the Henry Mountains. There's a population management section, which talks about genetics, disease, and limiting factors. The genetics is an important part of our herd population objective, and I'll get into more of that later in this presentation. It also has a habitat section, which has forage competition and agricultural depredation issues. Forage competition, especially during these really dry years, was a big issue. And then also there's the recreation part of this plan, which includes how we manage and hunt the bison herd on the Henrys. And then we get into the meat of the plan. The meat of the plan has the unit goals, and it has objectives and strategies for population, habitat, and recreation. And I'll talk about each of these separately. These are the overall broad goals for managing the bison herd on the Henrys. We want to maintain the Henry Mountains bison herd as a genetically viable free-roaming conservation population, balanced with available forage resources and long-term habitat capacity. We want to manage the bison population by providing diverse recreational opportunities, including hunting and viewing. And then we want to balance these herd goals and objectives with the impacts on human needs, such as livestock grazing, private property rights, and local economies. Our population objective is to maintain a population of 325 adults, and that's after all the hunts are over. This 325 number is important because we've found that information from the literature on bison genetic viability indicates that maintaining a minimal viable population of this size is important in preventing and inbreeding and maintaining genetic integrity and diversity. And roughly 325 equals about 400 animals with when you add the calves in. And this population of over 400 is important for this reason. The Henry Mountains bison population is considered a key population in maintaining the bison genome, and this is recognized on a national level as well. I want to mention too that it's important that we be willing to adjust the population size according to habitat conditions. And we are currently managing the bison herd at a lower level due to the recent drought. And we're hoping that when conditions improve, that we would be able to increase the number and get back to our population objective of 325. Another population objective is to maintain a sex ratio of 50 bulls per 100 cows. And that's important for maintaining older age class bulls for harvest. These are some of the strategies that we developed by the committee. One of them is monitoring, which is very important. We monitor harvest size or harvest through hunter surveys. And we also monitor population size. And there was a commitment by this committee to maintain our annual survey, our aerial survey, and also to continue satellite collar monitoring. So we want to be able to determine their use areas, their movements, and the timing of these movements. And also this having these collars can help us get a better population estimate from our surveys. We also annually monitor disease for brucellosis by collecting blood samples from hunters, and that is usually something that's required. Packets are sent out to all the hunters and we collect these samples, and we've been disease free since 1962 from brucellosis. Another aspect of the strategies are computer modeling. We use the computer modeling to compare and correlate with our aerial survey data. This committee, this was an important part of the committee discussion, was that we agreed to use the higher estimate of modeling or survey for our population management, which we use for setting permit numbers. One caution here is that models may overestimate a population, and if there is evidence that we had that it was, that we would want to be able to adjust the model. Another population strategy that was developed by this committee was that we would use the U.S. Drought Monitor Index for temporary adjustments to population size, which is what I had mentioned earlier that we had done. And we've been in the extreme drought for quite a bit, and that's why we've adjusted the population. Another strategy is that we preserve the genetic integrity and improve genetic heterozygosity. And we do that, as I mentioned earlier, by maintaining a herd size, an appropriate herd size. We also, when we reduce a population, we want to be able to consider the importance of bringing animals in to improve the genetic diversity. And then we have the habitat objective section. We have about 300,000 acres of bison habitat. And we want to continue to maintain and improve this habitat to support the population that we have. And this habitat is shared with livestock, so it's important to consider that into these objectives as well. Since 1960, we've had over 40,000 of habitat work on the Henry Mountains. More recently, DWR has, through WRI, has funded over 8,200 acres of habitat work. We also had a fire in 2003, which was approximately 34,000 acres, and that was reseeded with a seed mix to benefit bison. We want to continue these habitat projects as much as we can, and there is a part of the plan that has a habitat project list, proposed projects. Bison distribution is an important issue in forage availability and allocations. That's an important part of the plan, and we want to try and distribute bison, use strategies to distribute the bison to better utilize available habitat and minimize the conflict. And some of the strategies that we use that we'll talk about in the recreation section can affect bison use of the habitat. And these are some of the strategies for habitat. We talked about monitoring, which we want to identify use areas, and that's primarily through our satellite GPS collars. We can use those to look at areas that are critical during critical times. Also, when they move, we can identify important areas of use for bison. We also have a range crew that monitors the habitat every 5 years, and we look at plant composition trends to try and determine what's happening with the habitat. Also, one thing that we agreed through the committee process was that we would, when we consider habitat projects, we would prioritize projects in areas of livestock and bison conflicts. And that's a pretty important part of this strategy. We also wanted to say that we could utilize habitat strategies to minimize movements, which would hopefully help with conflicts with grazing. And some of that's through use of vehicles and OHVs and travel plans and some of our strategies that we have. We also have ongoing and proposed projects identified in the plan for forage and water developments. The next section is the recreation section, and these are the objectives for that section. We want to maintain high quality opportunities for hunters, and the population part of that, the objective where we said we were going to maintain the high bull cow ratio, that's part of that to maintain older age class bulls in the herd. This is a really high demand hunt. Since 1950, we've issued about 3,200 permits, and the demand for these permits are very high. Odds for a permit for a resident is about 1 in 100, and the chances for a non-resident is about 1 in 400. These are the strategies that were developed for a recreation objective. we want to maintain a high hunter success. Our hunter choice hunts are, the success is usually high. It varies though from 50 to 100%. In 2020, we had all three of our hunter choice hunts had 100% success, but that's not typical. Our 5-year average for hunter choice hunts is about 80% success. This is a neat hunt opportunity, and hunters usually want to share this experience with others. And so oftentimes they bring a lot of people with them for that experience, and also for the strong backs to help take care of an animal once it's harvested. So we've done management strategies such as multiple hunting seasons to try and minimize crowding as much as possible. We have several hunts. We have 3 hunter's choice hunts, and those are broken in between by a couple of days, short breaks to give the bison a opportunity to not be pursued for a couple of days. We also look at hunter access management. We have some areas where we want to be able to get the harvest, so we want to make sure we have access into those areas for hunters, but we also have areas where we may not want, where we may want the access restricted because we don't want the bison being pushed into areas where we're going to have more conflicts with livestock grazing. The other part of the recreation strategy is the public education. We want to utilize all media platforms to get the word out on this unique wildlife resource. What a great viewing opportunity this is in Utah. These bison live on a beautiful mountain with some spectacular scenery. And we want hunters and wildlife enthusiasts to enjoy this unique resource. And that's all I have. Thank you.